When Joe tells Matt's story, he always includes the part about Matt being a great athlete, and truly he was. To illustrate that point, Joe usually tells people that he has the home run balls to prove it. In the corner of a closet, I have a small wooden box. I call it my Matt box. In it are some pictures, a few of Matt's personal effects, some of his achievements, certificates and awards, and a baseball. I was looking at these things one day when I was all by myself. When I held that baseball in my hand, I realized a very important truth. When a person dies, they don't really take anything with them. Nothing. And certainly, no baseballs. If I were sitting across the couch from a young mom right now, I would tell them to make Christ the single priority of their life. Words are important. Actions are much more important. A child learns more from seeing than from hearing. If I wish for my child to make Christ a priority in their life, I must make him a priority of mine. There is certainly nothing wrong with softball, baseball, or most other activities. It can be good for your kids. Likewise, there is nothing necessarily wrong with Pilates, yoga, workouts, or a good pedicure. These can be good for you. There exists, however, a grave danger when we allow busyness to fill our lives to the place where we worry more about running an efficient taxi service than providing a godly home. Slow down, breathe, and hold your child close. We have no guarantee we will even be able to do that tomorrow. Today, I am grateful that I have an old battered baseball to hold in my hand and a box full of awards to look at. I am unbelievably more grateful that I have the assurance that Matt is at home with Christ. The next time you face one of these priority decisions, for your children or for you, put yourself in circumstances similar to mine. Then make the decision you will wish you had if this unthinkable tragedy should visit your home.